morning and Merry Christmas. I welcome you to worship today. I hope that you have had a joy-filled week remembering the birth of Jesus, our Savior and Lord. Our worship today is a collection of familiar readings, Christmas carols, and special music. Readers and musicians are from the Cashton Three Point Parish, Middle Coon Valley Lutheran Church, Campus Ministry students from the University of Wisconsin-La Crosse, and more. I hope that you will enjoy this worship and that you'll be reminded of the promise and the glory of God as we sing together and hear God's word. I'm Pastor Amanda Schultz Garcia, and I'm pastor here at Trinity Lutheran Church, as well as at Bethany and Emmanuel Lutheran Churches. It is my joy to partner with Pastor Meg Hoversten of Middle Coon Valley Lutheran Church, among others, for this worship today. Let us worship together.
Gather. Still in the Christmas season, we light our Advent wreath. This is a wreath my dad made for me many years ago. And the Sunday after Christmas, we get to light all five candles. So I hope in your own space at home, if you don't have an Advent wreath, you have some candles to light as we celebrate the birth of Christ, who brings light into our shadowed world. So let us pray. Loving God, as we have journeyed through Advent into this Christmas season, be with us now as we live out the good news of God with us. An all-powerful God, we pray that you continue to work in our world to scatter the shadows and bring your light and hope. This we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let's start with
okay. Okay.
A long time ago.
who shone in the Bethlehem manger and who spreads the Spirit's rays, be with you all. Let us pray. Almighty God, in the midst of our celebration of this holy season, help us find joy as we hear again the message of angels, and in heart and mind go to Bethlehem and see this thing that you have brought to pass. Help us find joy in the babe, your son, lying in the manger. Open your word as we hear the story of your love for all people. Help us hear anew the story of the birth, the holy child, who brings us forgiveness and salvation. We remember now all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater light, in that multitude that no one can number. We have faith that in Jesus we celebrate as one body with all your saints. We thank you for bringing your eternal light into our dark world. We bring you our offering of carols and lessons and readings and praise. Accept our gift of these praises for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Song of old, from angels bending near the earth to touch their harps of gold. Peace on the earth, goodwill to men, from heaven's all gracious King. The world in solemn still the angels sing.
So thankful that we are able to worship together as members and people of faith who live in Cashton and Coon Valley and Chaseburg, that we can come together to hear the good news of Christ, light of the world, and to hear songs and lessons. As we gather to celebrate Jesus, the bright morning star who shines light into the world. By day and night, he shines for all to see. Jesus was born in the midst of injustice and poverty, that the world may see the justice and richness of God. God so loved the world that he sent Jesus, so that all those who believe in him may not perish but have everlasting life. Indeed, God did not send him into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. Jesus is the light of the world. Jesus is the light of our lives. Sing to God a new song, a song of hope, joy, and peace for all the world.
A reading from the first chapter of Genesis. In the beginning, God creates the heavens and the earth. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while the wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. And God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate the day from the night, and let them be for signs and for seasons, for days and for years. And let them be lights in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth." And it was so. God made the two great lights, the greater light to rule the day and the lesser light to rule the night and the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth, to rule over the day and over the night. and to separate the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good.
To us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness. From that time on and forever, the zeal of Lord Almighty will accomplish this.
A reading from Micah, where the prophet Micah prophesies the glory of Bethlehem. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from old, from ancient days. Therefore, He shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure. For now he shall be great to the ends of the earth, and he shall be the one of peace.
Sun, the star shone forth, and angels sang. Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord of God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end."
Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" And the angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God. And now, your relative, Elizabeth, in her old age has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." And the angel departed from her.
While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. Word of God, word of life.
Child. if you wave. Merry Christmas.
Lesson 6. Shepherds are visited by God's messengers. Luke 2:8-14. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood over them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of the great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find the child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was an angel, a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors."
Glorifying and praising God for all they had seen and heard as it had been told to them. with truth and grace, and may makes the nations prove the glories of his righteousness and wonders of his love and wonders of his love and wonders, wonders of his love.
Let us pray. Holy God, let your word live in us richly. Please find a dwelling place in us as we have gathered to sing your praises, hear your word, rejoice in your promises, and soon go forth into your creation to be your humble servants. Gracious God, we come to you not as we ought, but as we are, with hearts unprepared for your coming and lives dusty with need. And yet you are born among us anyway. Strengthen us with hope through the birth of your Son. Grant us the eyes to see him born among us today in our neighbor. Give us strength to give gifts that truly matter this Christmas. May the God of grace empower us and give us peace. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. And let us continue with the prayer that our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Christ has come. Happy New Year. Happy New Year.